All right, hey, what's up guys, it's Roy here. And with today's video, I'm gonna be talking about Android 12 Beta 3 on my Google Pixel 4 that you see here in front of you. So this hit me on the over-the-air update yesterday. So I've had it for over 24 hours now. So I wanna give you my first impressions of it, all the new little features, and if you should update to Beta 3, if you are someone that's been kind of debating about doing it because of bugs and things like that. So I'll let you know if it is something that's a little more stable now that it's inching closer and closer to the actual stable release. So let's go ahead and jump right into it. So the first thing you're greeted with Beta 3 is your always on display here. Now it's not different than the other ones, but what is different I think is the ability that they've done with changing the clock colors and everything to match more of the background of my wallpaper here. So I just think they've done a better job with Material U. So I'm gonna go ahead and unlock my phone here real quick. So what I wanna talk about is, for example, like here, you see the new aqua color that I have here, just looks really clean. If I open that up and then scroll, you are able to see, you know, like the mic access to turn that on and off, the camera access, my location, all that here. The colors, I don't know, just looks a little bit better than it did originally. I much rather have more of a deeper black. There are some blacks here and there, but then you got some combination of like some gunmetal grays. And then if you go into the setting menus is different. You still have that Material U color here, but you do lose the color icons here. So it's just all more of just like a little more plain. But like say if you go into like display, then the Material U colors are present as well. If you go into the wallpaper and style setting here, it is completely refreshed. So it's getting closer and closer to that final build look, I think. You have the picture here of your lock screen and your home screen. You have the ability to change the wallpaper here. So you have this pill shape for the My Photos. You can go into like the Come Alives and check those out and kind of change the settings if you wanted to and all that. But I'm gonna stick with my icons wallpaper because I just really like it. But it does give you this opportunity now to pick some different colors that they've chosen for you that they think might match best and complement your wallpaper the best. I went with this one, but as you can see, it has three different colors because that's going to kind of implement those colors throughout the theme. But you can also force a color where if you just wanted to say do green, then it's going to change it to green. I can do this pinkish color, whatever. And as you can see, it changes here, changes here, changes everywhere. But I'm gonna go back and just go with what they've picked. And I really like this color here. Another thing that you can see here is this themed icons. If I turn that on, you can see that now up here, this looks different. So if I swipe out and go back to my home screen, this is different now. So all the Google apps are supposed to match more of that Material U color theme. So it's kind of this darker background with the greenish blue color. As you can see here, it's even changed the Google bar here as well. Another change is it's only the mic now again. So that is something that's new. I'm gonna go ahead and just go back to the basic look. I don't like that look, so I'd rather have it this way. The app grid looks a little bit different as well. So all in all, just different looks with the themes and all that as far as Material U goes. So getting closer and closer to that final build. Excited to see exactly how it looks like with that actual release. So another thing that they've added is the ability to kind of update your auto rotate. So if you go to hold that tile there, it brings you up to this auto rotate screen and it gives you this option now to enable face detection. So like it says here, face detection uses the front facing camera to improve auto rotate accuracy. So it's using the front facing camera to supposedly make the rotation quicker. So let's go ahead and test it out. And you tell me down in the comments if you think it's any faster. I personally don't, but then there's times where I think it is. I think it's just my brain telling me that it is because it says it's supposed to be. So another option that they've added to beta 3 is the ability to get rid of the swipe feature here to bring up your Google Assistant. So for whatever reason, there are plenty of people out there that don't like this ability. I still have my Pixel 4 here, so I have the squeeze features. So I do love that I can bring it up this way. I can also say, hey, you know what, and bring it up. So I have a couple of options. So if you have a Pixel 4a or newer, then you're really stuck to the swipe up or the hey, you know what. So if you want to turn it off, then you can go down into settings, scroll down to system, and then gestures, and then go down to system navigation, click the settings button there, and now swipe to invoke assistant. I can toggle it off, and now I don't have that ability. But if I go, if I go back, turn it back on, there it is. So that is just something that's added where if you want to take it off, you can, if whatever, you know, so just an added little feature there. So another feature that they've done, which I'm really, really, really excited about is, I don't know, let's just say I go to Twitter and let's say I want to do a scrolling capture of Twitter, right? Normally you can't on a Google Pixel, right? You can only do your screenshot, but with beta 3 now, you have the option to capture more. And this is going to give you the ability to do a scrolling capture of all this if I wanted to. So it's a feature I've absolutely loved on my Samsung Galaxy devices and other phones as well. But there are plenty of phones out there where you have to be forced to download a third-party app to do this, and usually it sucks. So this is an awesome feature, and I really love how Google has implemented it with this cool little magnifying glass here to be able to really pinpoint where you want it to stop. And then you can, you know, click the save button, or excuse me, click the edit button there, add text to it, whatever, save it. And now you have that whole entire captured view. So I really, really, really like it. Now, obviously with it being a beta, there is a bug where you are not able to do it with web browsers for some reason. So if I screenshot it, then I only have the ability to share or edit the screenshot. I do not have the capture more option. Obviously they're gonna fix that, but at least with beta 3, you do not have the ability to do it with Google Chrome and other web browsers. Something else that they've added is a really cool feature is this right here. When you swipe up and to like be able to close out your apps, you can see here in the corner, there's this feature little button here that I can click, and it's gonna give me the ability to copy or share the link to this web page. So I was on 9to5 Google here. I can send it directly to my wife if I wanted to, or I can click share and it will bring up all these other options of, you know, if I want to do like Facebook Messenger or Instagram or something like that. So I do like that little extra feature there to be able to share links a little bit easier. Of course, you have your screenshot and select text there. The animations are a lot smoother and looks a lot better. I can swipe down and it will bring it back to the full screen. But like I said, it just looks a lot cleaner when I'm swiping apps. Another cool thing is they fixed that glitch and that stutter with the apps here whenever you swipe out screens. So everything's just a lot smoother looking, as you can tell, just a lot cleaner, a lot more refined. So definitely really liking this beta 3 so far. Another thing that I've noticed, and this is just a little quirky thing, is the screen animation when I unlock the device. So on beta 2 and 2.1, at least for me on my Pixel 4, I had the animation when I was face unlocking the phone with the swipe feature or bypassing the swipe feature. I still had it. Now with beta 3, you only get the animation when you are unlocking it and bypassing the swipe up feature to unlock the phone. Now I prefer doing the swipe feature. That's just my opinion, because I like having notifications on my lock screen and actually being able to read them instead of just having the icons. But with the bypass of the swipe, you do get that face unlock animation and the haptics with it, because it does vibrate. So for example, if I unlock my phone, so I'm going to try to do that real quick and look at it. So as you can see here, it's unlocked, but I don't have any animation. It's just doing it and then I go. But let's say I go into settings And then I go to security and go to face unlock. Let me put in my code. And then now you see that I have the skip lock screen option. So if I do that, now you can see the animation. And it vibrates when it unlocks. So, well, I didn't do it that time. There we go. So, yeah, I don't know why. I mean, it's super quick. But it is something that I do miss because I did like that little ripple effect. It does it when you charge the phone too. Every time with wireless charging or plug-in, it gives you that ripple effect. So it's just a cool little added feature as well. So those are all the things that I've noticed with Beta 3. If I miss anything, let me know down in the comments, guys. So I said that I would give you my overall impression and my recommendation if you should update to Beta 3. So my impressions are good. The only thing that I've had issues with is my crypto app still isn't opening. I've done all the troubleshooting things, and for whatever reason, it just still was not open with beta. Everything else is working flawlessly. My Google Pay is working great. So everything's working just fine with the phone. I have not had any issues other than the crypto app. So it seems very stable, guys. I've really enjoyed it. I still wish that with Android 12 that they go to a more traditional look with the notifications. So for example, like, you know, like the app icon, I wish they would actually use the app icon instead of like this like material looking like fake app icon, and you know what I'm talking about. You know, at the end of the day, it is what it is. I mean, it looks good. I'm just looking forward to what it's gonna look with the final build. So if you are someone that's wanting to try out beta and really get a good taste of the Android 12 new features, I think beta 3 is safe enough to download. Like I said, I have not run into any issues at all. So hit that like button, guys, if you liked the video. If you loved it, please hit that subscribe button and ring that notification bell for up-to-date content. So be safe out there, and we'll see you on the next one.